Hi, good morning all of you. So in the previous class we discussed about magnetic field due to the straight wire. Means we discussed Biot Savart's law and direction of magnetic field produced by the current carrying conductor. And then we discussed about straight conductor there. Magnetic field due to the straight conductor of finite length first we discussed there. And based on that we discussed the different cases related to that semi-infinite and infinite length. Right? So as I said, that is one of the formula, finite length conductor formula, what you need to remember. And the next thing is this magnetic field with the circular arc. So magnetic field with the circular arc is another important formula you need to remember here. So the magnetic field with the circular arc means, just let us consider a circular current carrying conductor here having this radius r. Suppose I am assuming that it subtends an angle phi here, this total angle is phi, right? So then that is the total angle subtended by the circular arc, and r is the radius of this circular arc I am assuming here. And next here in this, suppose if you want to write like magnetic field at this center, we need to write here at the center of this circular arc. Then for that we need to take a small element here. So that small element I am taking like this. So the small element of this arc I am taking like this. So this is the small element what I am taking here. So this is the current element let us take here. So this I am taking at an angle theta with this, and this angle is d theta. So right? So just mention about that, describe the situation there. Consider a small circular arc of radius r, small circular arc of radius r carrying current I, sorry, circular arc of radius r, and mention about that phi, which subtend an angle of phi at its center, which subtend an angle of phi at its center. Let I is a current flowing through the circular arc. Let I is a current flowing through the circular arc. Then magnetic field due to the small element. Magnetic field due to the small element at its center, at the center of the arc, can be written as so I am going to apply our Biot-Savart's law here. Biot-Savart's law is mu naught by 4 pi into Idl sin theta we need to write here. So this is Idl sin theta. That theta is angle between the position vector r bar and dl bar. So right? So here dl bar will be along this tangential direction only. So that means Idl bar will be along this tangential direction only. So it makes an angle of 90 degrees with this radius here. Because tangent direction will give us Idl bar here. This is nothing but our r bar here. Radius vector is nothing but r bar there. So that angle between them is 90 degrees in this case here. So it is sin 90 by r square. That r square is nothing but radius itself you will get there. So that is the radius. So that you can write this expression as dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into I dl. The dl I can write this as length of this arc there. So length of that arc we can write as r d theta. So r d theta by r square you can write. Therefore this is dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into I by r into d theta we can write. So right? So that is our magnetic field due to the small element at its center there. Now we need to integrate this, because all the elements will produce a magnetic field in the same direction here. That means at this point all these elements, like current is flowing like this, so all the elements will produce a magnetic field into the plane only. So you can integrate that, right? So that means first you need to check that whether all the elements are producing the field in the same direction or not, right? For straight conductor in the previous class we discussed, straight conductor means all the elements will produce the same direction. And here also you can either apply either this right hand rule. That means like this you can verify curl, or you can verify for individual elements also you can verify here. They are producing the magnetic field in the same direction there. So the total magnetic field, now we can write this as, so the total magnetic field at that point will be equal to B is equal to, just we need to integrate this, mu naught I by 4 pi r is a constant value into integral of d theta. Only theta is a variable term there, right? And so now the theta value will varies from this 0 to phi. So So then theta value is varying from 0 to 5 here. Therefore, what I can write is this B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi r into 5. Right? So that is a formula to express this magnetic field produced by a circular arc here. So this is another formula what you need to remember here to solve the problems based on Biot-Savart's law. Right? One formula is based on the straight conductor. Conductor of finite length, which we discussed in our last class, like mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin alpha plus sin beta, right? That is one formula what we need to remember, and this is another formula what you need to remember here. Mu naught I by 4 pi r into 5, we need to, 5, where 5 is the angle subtended by the circular arc. Generally, whenever you are substituting directly, that angle substitution is there in any from any problem, not only in this, that angle must be substituted in radians. That means here also that 5 value, you need to substitute in radians, right? And so next. Now from this you can actually discuss like when the conductor is of semicircle or like a full circle, we can discuss such a points here, right? So let us write those points now regarding this. So that means now I am taking the circular 1/4 of the circle here. The magnetic field due to arc of 1/4 of the circle. So just to mention that. The magnetic field due to 1/4 of the circle. So 1/4 of the circle means just this angle will be equal to pi by 2 here, right? So therefore, for this what we can write is this pi is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, the magnetic field what we can write is mu naught I by 4 pi r into this pi is pi by 2, right? So therefore, it is mu naught I by 8 or you will get, so that 5 will be cancelled. So 1/4 of the circle if you consider for example, then this is the magnetic field produced here, mu naught I by 8 or you will get. So the magnetic field due to semicircle let us write here. So this is field due to a semicircle. So semicircle if we consider, for semicircle this pi value will be, suppose if you are taking like this, this is our center here, radius r. So that this angle will be equal to pi, right? So that means here simply what we can write is this phi we need to substitute it as pi. Therefore, this B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi r into pi. So instead of this phi, we need to substitute pi 180 degrees. So we can write this as B is equal to mu naught I by 4 r. So this is the magnetic field due to this semicircle here. So if you are taking that as a semicircular arc, then this is a magnetic field, right? Now next let us write for the complete circle. So field due to a circular coil. So circular coil. At its center, we are all finding at its center of the circular arc only. So now if you are taking this is a complete circle here, this is a circle of radius r carrying some current I. Then magnetic field means, that circle means then phi value we need to substitute as. So therefore here this phi is equal to 2 pi. For complete circle means you know that angle will be 2 pi. And therefore you can write this expression as B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi r into 2 pi, right? So therefore this B value we can write this as mu naught I by 2 r you can write. So that 2 and pi will be cancelled there. So mu naught I by 2 r. So this is a magnetic field at the center of this circular coil. So if you are taking the complete circle, it's just a mu naught I by 2 r, right? And now in this coil, in the same circular coil, if the coil is having n number of turns, so wire is wound for n times in the same circular coil, then ni we need to write here. So each coil will produce this magnetic field. So n times means then we need to multiply with that n. So that means mention that also there. If coil has n turns, so I will write here. If coil has n turns, then mention that mu naught ni by 2r. Just add that point there. If circular coil has n number of turns. So n turns, then this B is given by, then magnetic field is given by total magnetic field mu naught ni by 2r, right? So it is a magnetic field at the center here. The magnetic field at the center of the circular coil is given by this expression here. So just we need to write it as mu naught ni. We need to write, if only one turn is there, mu naught I by 2r you will get. If n number of turns are there, then we need to multiply with that n. So this is a magnetic field due to this circular arc at its center. So for axial point we will discuss it later, the magnetic field due to the circular arc, that means circular ring at any point on its axis, we will discuss it later. This is at the center, right? So the basic formula is mu naught I by 4r, mu naught I by 4 pi r into phi, where phi is the angle subtended at that point, we need to write there, right? The total angle subtended by the arc. So with the help of these two expressions, we can solve lot of problems based on this Biot-Savart's law here, right? So let us see a few problems based on this Biot-Savart's law here, and after that I will explain about magnetic field to the circular or circular coil on its axis. So let us write some problems based on this. So to solve the problems based on this, the thing is you need to identify how many different parts of that circuit, that means how many parts we can divide the given figure. So that means we need to consider that different parts and magnetic field due to all parts we need to identify there. First we need to identify the direction, and then we need to write the magnitude due to the each part, and then we need to add them vectorically. If they are in same direction we should add them, and if they are in different directions we need to subtract them, right? So I will start with this, some simple problems there based on this. And so just write a common problem there, like find magnetic field at the point O, in the following cases. Find magnetic field at point O in the following cases. So the first thing I am writing here, suppose if I am taking these current carrying conductors, two current carrying conductors lying in the same plane and they are carrying the same current, let us consider. So this is I and I. So for this let us consider this separation is D here, right? And so now this is our point O here at the midpoint. So this is a point O at a distance of D by 2 from this either of this conductor. And remember this, if conductor, just some diagram is given there and there is no information regarding its length, then you need to consider that length as an infinite length. Remember that formula, remember that case. If it is a finite length, definitely they will mention information about this length. That means if such a diagram is given for us, you need to consider that both the conductors are tending to infinity only, right? So that is the important thing you should note here. In every problem they won't mention like about the information like they are infinitely conductor. Just they will give the diagram, and if they are asking that length means, we need to consider that conductor as tending to infinity. Infinite length we need to consider here. So first I will explain for this problem here what we need to consider there. So first what I am taking here is, so two parts are there here. This is magnetic field due to this conductor we need to calculate, and magnetic field due to this conductor we need to calculate, right? So that means I am taking that B1 and B2 let us consider here. The magnetic field due to this let us consider it as B1, and magnetic field due to this let us take it as B2 here. So that's first of what I am taking, what I am saying there. If suppose four parts are there, then B1, B2, B3, B4 you need to assume. After assuming that, identify the direction of the magnetic field due to each part. So let us identify the direction of magnetic field due to this part at this point O. We need at the point O. O means the right side of, that means the right side of this first conductor, that point lies. So then we need to apply our Ampere's right hand thumb rule. So if you are applying this Ampere's right hand thumb rule, the current is flowing in upward direction there. So the magnetic field lines will be there like this. So our point is lying this side for first conductor. So here field lines are entering into the plane. So right, so here the field lines are entering into the plane. So I can mention that the B1 direction is into the plane here. The magnetic field to the first conductor is into the plane. And next we need to write, identify the direction of magnetic field due to the second conductor. The magnetic field due to the second conductor. So now for this conductor also current is flowing in outward direction. That means upward direction only. So now the field lines are there like this. The field lines are circulating like this. Now our point is this side here. Our point is on the left side of this conductor. Our point is on the left side of the conductor means here the field lines are coming out here. The field lines are coming out here. So the field lines are coming out means then you can write this as the magnetic field at that point is out of the plane, right? So that now what I can conclude here is the net magnetic field is, therefore this net magnetic field at that point is B1 plus B2, we need to B1 bar plus B2 bar you need to write here. That means vector addition, what I am saying. So that therefore the net field is mu naught I by, this is infinite conductor. So right, so mu naught I by 4 pi d, I can write both for both of them. First I am writing the magnitudes here. So magnitudes let us first write here, B1 and B2 both are equal in magnitude because both the same current is flowing and for both of them the distance is also same there, right? So then sin pi by 2 plus sin pi by 2. So both are infinite conductors only. Infinite conductor is pi by 2, pi by 2, or if you remember that formula mu naught I by 2 pi r, you can directly apply that formula, 2 pi d formula, right? So then here this d is nothing but d by 2, right? The distance is half here. So then we need to substitute this expression as, so therefore this b1 is equal to b2 is equal to mu naught I by pi into d you will get here. So here 1, 2 you will get, and this is another here the by 2 is there, that will be cancelled there. Now therefore the magnetic field at that point is, net magnetic field at that point is, so mu naught I by 4 pi d, that means pi d minus mu naught I by pi d we need to consider here, right? Why we are taking this negative sign means here I took positive sign and here I am taking negative sign. Is there any confusion? Here this is a vector addition here. Now I am substituting the magnitudes. If this is say plus k cap before taking, for example, this if you are taking plus k cap, and other will be minus k cap, you will get. One is into the plane and other is out of the plane, you may consider there. So one is, both are opposite each other here. Both are opposite each other, so that we need to take that negative sign. So that there is no magnetic field at that point here, right? So that is, that magnetic field at that point is zero. Is it clear? So like that you need to check for every problem here. Whatever the given problem is there, first you need to identify the elements there. How many magnetic fields are there? That means magnetic current carrying elements are there. So magnetic field due to each element we need to mark like B1, B2, B3, and let us identify the directions there. In the same case, let us take another example here. If the current is in opposite direction there. Suppose say this is a current carrying conductor carrying some current I in upward direction, and I am taking current I in downward direction here. So separation is same d, and so now our point is O here. So right now simplify that, you need to calculate that. I explained the first one, and here now we need to identify here the direction of the magnetic field as well as this magnitude you need to find here, right? Now next, suppose now I am taking this, let us take an arrangement like this. So current is flowing like this, and we need this magnetic field at this point here. The magnetic field at this point P, such that it makes an angle of theta by 2 and theta by 2 here, right? And so then this distance I am giving here, this distance is given as d. So current I is flowing there. So write that. And my second same question, like this is a point O, let us take. We are writing a common question here. So that means just like our conductor is in the form of this V shape is there, right? So V shape is there. So we need to find this magnetic field at this point O here. From this it is, from this junction it is given as some distance d, right? So again here we need to take that as a two parts. Magnetic field will be there because of these two parts here. So magnetic field, first let us identify those two parts here. First I am taking magnetic field, this is the first part and this is the second part I am taking there. So the magnetic field, the first part say B1 and due to this second part B2. Let us identify the directions there first. So the magnetic field due to this first conductor. So current is flowing like this. So few lines are there like this. So that is circle. They are entering into the plane. So few lines are entering into the plane here. So they are entering into the plane means B1 is into the plane. Next, let us identify for this B2 here. So that means B2 conductor is there like this. So for this also the field lines are coming like this. That means this side our point is lying this side here. So the field lines are entering into only this side. They are coming out here. So the field lines here also for B2 also that will be into the plane only, right? And therefore, what we can write is that net field is equal to B1 plus B2. We can write. Just we need to add their magnitude. That means vector addition is there. And here both are in same direction, so we need to add these magnitudes there, right? And so now let us write this B1 and B2 expressions here. So B1 and B2 both are again same because the angle is same. That both are symmetrical point we are considering there, so that I can say that their magnitudes are equal. And so now here let us write. Let us apply our formula here. Mu naught I by 4 pi. D, that means D means here I am writing like R perpendicular into sine alpha plus sine beta. Is it clear what I am writing? R perpendicular, because this distance is already given as D, but we should not substitute that D there. So our formula, in our formula, perpendicular distance from the conductor we need to substitute here. So the perpendicular distance from the conductor means we may mention like this here. So this is the perpendicular distance here. So this is a perpendicular. So this is our perpendicular distance there, R perpendicular. So just by using the triangle, you can write that. Suppose I am writing that sine theta by 2 there. So then sine theta by 2 you need to write here. And that alpha and beta values also you need to identify here. Alpha and beta are also those are not mentioned in this diagram here, right? So that means first I am writing all the data here. Here R perpendicular is equal to D sine theta by 2. Is this clear? This is a right angle triangle what you need to consider. So in that right angle triangle our perpendicular is this one. So sine theta by 2 you can write here. Sine theta by 2 is equal to R perpendicular by this hypotenuse, you will get a D, right? And so then that is nothing but R perpendicular is equal to D sine theta by 2 you will get. Next I am writing this alpha and beta values. So alpha value in that problem is, our alpha meaning is in our general formula, the angle made by this, the current carrying conductor here, the line angle made by the line joining from this end of the conductor with this perpendicular here. This is our alpha and this is our beta there, right? So now according to this, in this alpha is nothing but this theta by 2 is not alpha here. This is our alpha here, one angle, right? So alpha means that one we need to consider there. So that angle is nothing but 90 minus theta by 2 you can write here. So that angle I am taking it as 90 minus theta by 2. And that beta value you can consider that as pi by 2. Because the other end tends to infinity there. So any one angle, like if you are taking alpha as 90 degrees, then beta value will be this angle you will get. So therefore you can write this expression, you can substitute these values in that. Therefore our B1 is equal to B2 is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into 4 pi d means d sine theta by 2 into this is sine of 90 minus theta by 2 plus sine 90, right? And so therefore you can express this as mu naught I by 4 pi d sine theta by 2 into this value will be, you will get like 1 plus cos theta by 2 you will get. That means sin 90 is 1 and this is sin of 90 minus theta by 2 means cos theta by 2 you will get. So then we need to substitute that B1 and B2 values here so that you will get the net magnetic field there. So therefore that net magnetic field is B1 plus B2 we need to write. So just you can multiply this with the 2, mu naught I by 4 pi d into this expression is like sin theta by 2 into 1 plus cos theta by 2 into 2, because B1 and B2 both are same there. Therefore this net magnetic field what we can write is mu naught I by 4 pi, that means we will get then this as 2 pi d into sin theta by 2 into this is 1 plus cos theta by 2 you can write. Right? So that is the expression what we can write there. If any further simplification, trigonometric simplification is there, you can write by using depending on the options there. Depending on the options, you can further simplify that. Right? And then this is the another case here. That means now let us take the next problem. Like suppose now here I will take a problem like this. So this angle I am taking as some theta there. So this is the case I am taking here. This is our point O. So current is I. So the magnetic field at that point now we need to find there. The magnetic field at that point O we need to find there. So that means now the O is in the same line of this conductor and so current is flowing I am taking like that. Or you may take in opposite direction also. There is no problem with the direction of the current. Just field direction will change there, right? So then again I am taking this as suppose the magnetic field due to this one is I am taking it as B1 here. The magnetic field due to this at this point and this is B2 I am taking here. So just you need to identify the direction of that magnetic field due to those two points as we are following from the for the past three problems there. So the magnetic field to the first conductor will be at that point means you can assume that if the conductor may be extended like this. So the magnetic field due to this conductor at the point O will be into the plane, right? So that magnetic field will be there into the plane. So B1 is into the plane. Now can you say the magnitude of this? That means the magnetic field due to this conductor. So this conductor you need to observe it carefully. The conductor is, this point is lying in the same line of this conductor. So whenever point is lying in the same line of conductor, the magnetic field due to that will be zero. So the magnetic field due to this conductor will be zero, right? So only magnetic field due to this conductor we need to substitute there. So for that I will draw this diagram again here and I will explain here. So this is our conductor is lying here. So which makes an angle theta this with this horizontal. So this is our point here, our point is lying here, right? So now let us observe this here, you need to solve this carefully here. So I am extending this problem now, that means I am extending this conductor here. Suppose I am extending this conductor until this, so that you can draw this normal here. So that means here from this I am drawing this normal. So right, so this will be now R perpendicular, perpendicular distance here. So this is our given distance is D here, right? And so then this angle is, if this angle is theta, then this angle will be theta. And so that this angle will be, I can say this 90 minus theta, right? So this is our case now. So now from this we need to write the magnetic field, right? So the magnetic field in this case means, so in this case you need to apply our formula as, so now both the angles are above this normal only we need to consider here. So observe this carefully here. So here the formula is magnetic field due to this first conductor is mu naught I by 4 pi d into 4 pi d means here r perpendicular. I am writing the formula here sin alpha minus sin beta we need to substitute here. This formula we need to use because you need to observe this. These angles, that means this is the perpendicular here, one angle is drawn from here, the other angle will be tending to this 90 degrees here, that means it tends to this other end here. So that means now our case is similar to this here actually. Conductor is here, we are finding the magnetic field at this point here. So this what actually is, this is the normal what we are drawing. So this is one angle what we are taking here, the other angle tends to 90 degrees here. So other angle, this angle tends to 90 degrees and this is the one angle here. So these are the angles what we are taking there, right? So that means now this is the perpendicular here. So now both this alpha and beta are on the same side only. On the same side means in the last class I explained clearly, if alpha and beta are defined on the same side of the normal, then our formula will be sin alpha minus sin beta we need to consider there, right? So now let us write this formula here. So here I am first writing these expressions there. So that means first r perpendicular I am writing here. So that r perpendicular is d sin theta. just by using this right angle triangle here. This is the distance d and this is our perpendicular distance. And next is alpha value tends to 90 degrees. That means alpha is pi by 2 you can consider, because this n tends to infinite here. Nothing is mentioned means we need to take that as infinite only. So now this beta value is this angle here. So that angle is 90 minus theta you may consider here, right? So now let us substitute these expressions here so that you will get this magnitude. That means that net magnetic field is now nothing but B1 plus B2. So therefore this net magnetic field is B1 is nothing but this expression here, mu naught I by 4 pi d, the d is nothing but d sine theta perpendicular distance into sine pi by 2 plus sine 90 minus theta plus 0. The other angle will be 0. That means the B2 value will be 0 here. You can also write pi by 2. So the other angle, that means other magnetic field with the other conductor will be 0. So right? So therefore this is net magnetic field. You can write this expression as mu naught I by 4 pi d sin theta into 1 plus cos theta. So then if you want, you can further simplify these expressions there just by using our trigonometric relations. Like in the previous problem also I said, that depends on the further simplification there. Like you can write this as cos theta value, you can write this as cos 2 theta value, you can write this as this is cos theta is there. So 1 plus cos theta value we need to write here. So I can write this as cos square theta by 2 minus 1 you can write there, right? By taking that 2 cos square theta by 2 and minus 1 you can write there, and you can simplify this further here. So that this cos theta plus 1 you can write this as 2 cos square theta by 2. And that you can do the further simplification, because this trigonometry you know very well. The sin theta value you can write as 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 you can write, and you can further simplify that expressions there. That depends on, as I said, that depends on the options how they are expressing there. So like I can write this as further simplification means that the B net is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into this value, and numerator value I am writing as 2 cos square theta by 2, and this sin theta value we can write as 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 you can express there, because this is sin theta is there. So therefore this net magnetic field you can express this as mu naught I by 4 pi d into cot theta by 2 we can write, because that cos theta and 1 cos theta by sin theta you will get. So this will be the expression for this magnetic field there, right? So like that we need to calculate their magnetic field due to these different arrangements. And now next, based on this only, let us write, I will give one more problem here, you need to solve that. So then I am giving this problem like this. So this is the distance d I am taking here. This is our point O, and this angle 90 degrees I am giving here. Like suppose a current I is flowing like this. Similar to this only, here magnetic field due to one conductor is 0 here. Now their magnetic field due to both the conductors you need to calculate there, right? So both the conductors you need to solve. A similar calculation only, this type of calculation only you will get. So this is the need of applying that. So you need to remember this. By mistake if you write this, so I consider here it as, this is plus sign I substituted there here. So let us substitute this as minus sign. So I think then you will get the wrong calculation, this total calculation. So let us substitute that as a negative sign there. So then this value is 1 minus cos theta you will get, right? Then 1 minus cos theta means then you need to apply like the further simplification, as I said, trigonometry. This we can write this as by using cos 2 theta formula there. So it is cos theta is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square theta by 2 you will get, right? So this is nothing but now 1 minus cos theta, you will can replace it as 2 sin square theta by 2. So now you will get in terms of the sine, you will get here. So this expression, now you can write this as 2 sin square theta by 2, you can write here. So that this can be written as tan theta by 2, you can write. Right? So that is a change there, small calculation mistake there. So that means now this is the only important thing here. That means we need to write this minus sign here. That means sine alpha minus sine beta we need to write there, right? So then apply such a similar formula for this and do that calculation for that. Next, let us see one more problem here. So, I am taking the situation like this. This is so that this angle I am taking as 30 degrees and 30 degrees here. So this is a conductor will be there like this. So I mean this will be there like this. So this will extend up to infinity here. This tends to infinity. So the current directions I will represent here so that you will get some clarity here. So current is say somewhere it is entering here, so that this will be the flow of this current is taking place like this. That means if this end is closed, then this end will be open here. So that such a continuation will be there. And so now the distances are also mentioned, that will be mentioned like this. This will be A for example, then this is also A. And so then this gap is also A like this. So that means each gap is also A here. So the magnetic field at this point O we need to find in this case here. So magnetic field at this point O, right? So this is simple only, somewhat simple only, because the angles and perpendicular distance, everything will be same, similar to our standard definitions or standard formula there, right? So the magnetic field due to the thing is what we need to observe here is the magnetic field due to this first conductor, for example, if you consider here, let us say this is B1, B2 and B3 like this. So, B1 means magnetic field due to this conductor at this point all I am taking here. For that conductors I am representing here, B2, B3 and B4 like this, right? So, I observe this sign, the directions there. So, the magnetic field to this first conductor is at this point. So, the field lines are out of the plane here. Current is flowing here, so the field lines are out of the plane. That means here the field due to this first conductor is out of the plane. Now field due to the second conductor here. Field to the second conductor will be there like this. So that means current is flowing in downward direction. So that will be into the plane. So now field due to the third conductor. So the third conductor will be there like this. So it will be out of the plane. That means alternatively will get like this. So one is out of the plane and other is into the plane, you will get like this. And the magnetic field due to these conductors. That means here some part is there here like this. So, magnetic field due to those parts will be 0, because you can observe that point is lying along the same line here. That point O will lies along the same line of those two parts there. So, that means magnetic field due to those parts will be 0. Only we need to calculate these magnetic fields here, right? So, I will write B1 and B2 expressions so that you will get the clarity about that, how to write those expressions there in general. So, I am writing this B1 expression there. So, B1 is nothing but mu naught I by 4 pi d. So, now the d is nothing but this one we need to write here. So, at that distance we can write this as this side is A is given for us. So, this will be the perpendicular distance here. So, that perpendicular distance we can write as A cos 30, right? So, that will be the perpendicular distance. And next to this sine 30 plus sine 30 you can write there. Sine 30 plus sine 30. Because this angle is 30 and this angle is also 30. And so that what we can write here is mu naught I by 4 pi A into 2 tan 30. Right? 2 tan 30. Let us substitute that value later. Now the B2, this is B1 expression here. So now B2 value I am writing here. Mu naught I by 4 pi. Now this B2 is nothing but perpendicular distance up to here we need to calculate. So up to here means then this triangle you need to cancel this. Side of this triangle will be 2a then hypotenuse. So then you will get 2a cos 30. So like that, that will be the change there. So 2a cos 30 into these angles will remain same. Sin 30 plus sin 30. Right? And therefore this expression. 4 pi into 2a, 2 tan 30. That means this here 2 sin 30 by cos 30, that will be 2 tan 30. That will remain same there. So like that every term you will get that those except here a and next 2a and for this you will get 3a. So that will be only be the change there. So therefore I am writing this net magnetic field here. So let us write the net magnetic field direction, that means that resultant magnetic field at that point. So the resultant magnetic field at that point, you can write this as net magnetic field is equal to. So B1 minus B2 plus B3 minus B4 plus B5 and so on. Infinite terms we need to write like this. Because one if you are taking like out of the plane if I am taking as positive, then into the plane you need to consider as negative because fields are opposite in direction. And therefore what you can write here is mu naught I by 4 pi into 2 tan 30 I am taking common here. Observe this. 2 tan 30 I am taking common. So that means except this perpendicular distance, remaining everything will be same for all the conductors, right? Except the directions. For directions, we are already considering that negative sign there. So then for first one, our perpendicular distance will be like a you will get. Cos 30 also we are taking the out here. So 1 by a minus 1 by 2a plus 1 by 3a minus 1 by 4a plus and so on, infinite. So this will be the series what we are getting there. So let us write that a also outside. So I can further simplify this as mu naught I into 2 tan 30 by 4 pi a. Then this is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus and so on here, infinite. So then I think all of you know that this is nothing but our expression for ln 2, logarithmic expression here. So that what I can write here is mu naught I by tan 30 by 2 pi a into ln 2. So that is ln 2. Now here sometimes you need to observe this carefully here. So by keeping this value as 4 pi itself, then they will write here 2 also, they will write here. That means you need to observe these options carefully here. So that means this expression what we can write is finally this net magnetic field is mu naught I into tan 30 is 1 by root 3 will get. So I can substitute that tan 30 value. So this is 2 root 3 pi a into ln 2, right? So this is our expression. So sometimes it will be given as mu naught I by 4 root 3 into pi a ln 4. So they will give like this. So that means now that means here this 2 also if you are keeping this 2 or just we are multiplying and dividing with the 2 here. So 2 ln 2 means you can write that as ln 2 square. So ln 2 square is nothing but 4. So that means here if 4 is there, then here 4 should be there. So that you should note there. So then otherwise here 2 is there, then here ln 2 will be there. So sometimes they will confuse the options there like this. So this is a problem for such an infinite series there, right? And next actually some combinations will be there, like I will give this one square and triangular problem and so try to solve those problems there. I think think this will be I forgot the serial number, so whatever the serial, note that. I hope it is 6th one. So right, and so then this is now I am taking this square like this, square loop. So the magnetic field due to this square loop we need to calculate here. This is I, and at the center this is L by 2. Our point is L by 2. So the magnetic field due to these four conductors, let us calculate there. Then we need to identify the directions there, and accordingly need to answer that. And similarly, I am taking this triangular there. Suppose I am taking that as some equilateral triangle of side L. So this is our point O, centroid of the triangle. So this I is the current flowing through this, right? And so such a closed loops, many arrangements will be given there. So you need to identify that, and you need to solve those problems there. Like sometimes they will give some polygon here. So try that problem also, or otherwise I will explain it tomorrow. Like I mentioned that it's a polygon of n sides. A wire of length 2 pi r. A wire of length 2 pi r is bent into the closed loop of closed polygon of n sides. Closed polygon of n sides. So let us write small n sides. If I is a current flowing through that closed loop, if I is a current flowing through the closed loop, then find the magnetic field. Then find the magnetic field at the center of the closed loop. At the center of the closed loop. Right? That means you need to identify that magnetic field there, and then that means magnetic field due to one wire. In these, all these problems in the regular arrangements, what I can say here is the magnetic field due to one wire, if you find, then you can multiply with the 4 there in the, such a regular arrangements. Like, because if you are taking, for example, square here, the magnetic field due to this wire will be into the plane, and magnetic field due to this wire will be into the plane, because current will flow like this. And magnetic field due to this wire is also into the plane, and magnetic field due to this wire is also into the plane. So all the 4 wires are producing the magnetic field in the same direction, right? And by the symmetry, you can also say that their magnitude will also be same, because for this conductor, our point is L by 2. And the angles made by this conductor is also same here. So this is our angle here, 45 degrees. And this angle you can take it as 45 degrees there. So that angles is same, as well as this distances are also same. So that this whatever the magnetic field produced by this first wire, for example, then all these 4 wires will produce the same magnetic field. So first you may write the expression for magnetic field due to this one wire, and you can multiply with the 4. And similarly here, you may calculate with one wire, and you can multiply with the 3. And then similarly here, so the magnetic field due to one wire you may calculate there, and you can multiply with the n, because their n sides are there in that polygon. So for that you need to write this, the angles calculation is important here, angles calculation, and then this perpendicular distance calculation there. So just angle calculation means what I can say here is, so like simple, for taking a regular hexagon, let us consider there. For this hexagon, if I consider there, so what is the angle subtended by the each side at its center? So just to consider it as a regular hexagon. So that means angle means what I am saying is, if suppose this is the center of this hexagon, this angle I am asking here. So that angle, the total angle you can write that as, for the regular hexagon, so it is 2 pi by 6 you can write. So the total angle is 2 pi. It is divided by the 6 sides there, because they are taking that, we are taking that 6 sides, right? So then that is nothing but you can say it as a pi by 3, the total angle. And so now similarly here, n sides we are taking here. So n sides means then this total angle will be, this total angle is like 2 pi by n you will get, the total angle. So to write the magnetic field due to this one side, so that means that n sides will be there like this. Just I will explain this concept, you can solve that easily. So now this is the case here, right? So now n sides means then this is the angle subtended here. This total angle is given by this. So to write the magnetic field to this one wire, we need this calculation here. See this. So this is the distance. That means this is the perpendicular distance here, and these are the angles what we need to write here. So this angle you can consider it as pi by n, half of this, right? Total angle is 2 pi by n. So half that angle is pi by n. So the magnetic field due to this wire, one wire, you can write this as mu naught I by 4 pi into that r perpendicular. You need to write there that r perpendicular means this side. Suppose if I consider this as, for example, a, that a means you can write that n a is equal to 2 pi r. Finally you may write that, just I am taking it as some a. Then this is nothing but a right angle triangle. So we need to write this side here. So that side you can write this as a by 2. This side is a by 2. So you can write this as tan theta. You can write there, suppose tan phi I am taking there. So I will write this perpendicular distance first, and then I will explain this magnetic field equation there. So that r perpendicular I am writing here. So for that, what I am taking is tan pi by n is equal to a by 2 by r perpendicular. This side will be a by 2 and this will be r perpendicular. Therefore our r perpendicular is equal to a by 2 tan pi by n. This is our r perpendicular there. So therefore this is the magnetic field due to this one wire I am writing here. So the magnetic field due to this one wire, what we can write is mu naught I by 4 pi into perpendicular distance. So the perpendicular distance is 2 by 2 tan pi by n, right? This is totally our perpendicular distance into sine alpha plus sine beta. You need to write, so that is sine of pi by n plus sine pi by n. You can write, because both are same. This angle is pi by n and this angle is also pi by n. You will get, because the total angle is 2 pi by n. And so now that we can further simplify that as so that means now you can further simplify this here. So that is B1 is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi into A into 2 tan pi by n, right, into this will be 2 sin pi by n, 2 sin pi by n, right? And therefore this B1 is equal to mu naught I by pi into A. So it is tan pi by n into sin pi by n. You will get tan pi by n and sin pi by n. You will get, and then A also you can replace here. So where A is given by, where na is equal to, so write that a calculation also. We need to eliminate that a also there. So but this na is equal to 2 pi r. Therefore a is equal to 2 pi r by n. You can write, and therefore I substitute that. So you can write that expression as there, like b1 is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi square r into n into tan pi by n into sin pi by n. This is only magnetic field due to one wire here. Such n wires will be there again. So the net magnetic field means you need to multiply with this n here. So therefore this net magnetic field is n into b1. You can write, is it clear why we are taking, like here if you are taking three sides, four sides, three sides, and there it will be n sides. So that this expression finally what you can write is mu naught I n square by 2 pi square into r. So then tan pi by n into sin pi by n. So that will be our total magnetic polygon of n sides and length 2 pi r. If L is given, in terms of L you can write there, right? So those are some problems based on that. And now in this class, just we are discussing related to the straight wires only. And next I will explain, in the next class I will explain the combination of the circular arcs and this straight wires, right? Thank you.